Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Aiden Zero. Today I'm going to be joined by Boss Foxy 3232. This is The Wave Iceberg Explained.
S&P On Air is S&P Wave. If you didn't know or couldn't already tell, S&P On Air is the same as S&P Wave. We changed our name for a couple of reasons that we will get to later in the iceberg.
West S&P. This is the server that I ran in between the end of S&P On Air and the start of S&P Wave Season 1. On it was a bunch of the Wild West crew and our friends. While it didn't run for very long, it was a lot of fun.
Ride the Wave. This is the slogan that some of the members used as promotional material for the S&P. If you haven't already, check out some of the stuff we do.
Poguin. This was the town that I made on S&P On Air. It had an entire presidential administration that included myself, Zach, Baldy, and Boss. People would come from all over the world to build and make things in Poguin. Boss cites the various stories surrounding Poguin as the peak of that server.
Wave's expansion. Simply put, it's more than just a Minecraft server now. Wave has expanded into a group, resulting in the group doing a lot more content in different areas than just Minecraft.
Salt S&P. This is the S&P where a lot of the on-air crew met, including myself, Griffin, Zach, Tommy, Jude, and Evan. Unfortunately, that server ended due to miscommunications, which led to Griffin creating on-air. Komodo Hype Dynasty. This refers to the dynasty Boss was going to create in the first season of S&P Wave, but for reasons that we'll get into later down the iceberg, it was never fully realized.
Askershire. Askershire was a country that was founded by Jude and Evan towards the end of S&P On Air. It was considered as one of the best projects on the server. The consistency in the builds combined with two Brits running around all the time led to an awesome vibe around there. Griffin was late. It was 12 PM Eastern, trailers were live, and so were the boys. Everybody sat in a VC waiting for Griffin to open the server. That was the first season of S&P Wave. Luckily, he was only less than an hour late and everything ran smoothly. Well, as smoothly as it could, speaking of...
Server lag. The day the first season of Wave started, the server lag was so unbearable that many people got off within just a couple hours of it starting. I myself was going to do a 24-hour stream, but the lag, combined with me getting slightly motion sick, led me to ending a little bit early.
Canceled lore.
This segment will cover all of the lore that we had planned for S&P On Air.
First of all, we had an arc planned for Shinobi to carry out in which he would find various Infinity Stones all over the world, including the old S&P On Air map. There was a festival in Pogland, which was supposed to be carried out as the season finale, where Aiden revealed his secret to everybody. We'll cover that later in the iceberg. At the end of the season, everybody would get in a rocket ship that would take everybody to the new season. Baldy was supposed to be used as a mythical-like being. To tie the loose ends with the new members, there was going to be like a vortex or something we had planned. We didn't go that far yet. All the government members in Pogland would enter, and they'd appear in the second season of On Air. Later in the season with all the new members, so it would make sense for the new members to join. But that was scrapped, along with the lore.
Alright, that's all the lore, let's get back into it. Shinobi. One of the players on the S&P that ended up being banned for reasons that will be covered. As stated, he was planned to be a major factor in the S&P's lore.
Omar. Omar was Shinobi's friend who never spoke until S&P Wave started, even though he was on S&P On Air.
Season 1's abrupt ending. Within the first week of Season 1 starting, there were multiple incidents of hacking, x-raying, stealing, and griefing. This led to lots of inactivity within the group, which resulted in the end of the season.
New Pogland. This was something else that I had planned for the first season of S&P Wave. Like the name implies, this would carry on the legacy Pogland left behind while also serving as a spiritual successor of sorts. This would have been its own independent nation and would not have been annexed by Swagstead. One Trick Mage Race. This is something else that happened in between SMP On Air and Wave SMP Season 1. I was speedrunning a game called One Trick Mage. It's like a short little 2D platformer that had a very tight speedrun. Aiden saw this and thought he would step back into the speedrunning scene, as it's been months since he ran Odyssey and Mario 64. While he got within under 10 seconds, he never beat my time in the end. You suck, Aiden.
Boss Foxy 3232 on the West SMP. Since Boss was in the West Discord, he once made a brief but eventful appearance on the West SMP. It was confusing to everybody, especially the people who didn't know him, but in the long run, it became one of the more memorable moments to come out of that server for sure.
Servault. Servault is the alt Minecraft account that Servos once used to troll myself and Aiden. It was probably the only funny thing that happened on that first season of Wave. Name change. When coming up with the name for On Air, we didn't realize that there was another SMP of the same name. We were going to keep the name the same even after talking with the people on the other SMP. Everything was fine until some of the members put out a hit document detailing some of the things that happened behind the scenes over there on their server. This led to a public cancellation, which we all saw play out live on Twitter. To not have any association with the other SMP On Air, we changed our name to Wave.
The Pussy Patrol. This happened on Season 1 of Wave. Coined by Boss, this refers to the group of players that Shinobi would manipulate into doing crimes for him. However, word got out quickly of his affiliations, which allowed the rest of the server to keep a more watchful eye.
Surgical Summer. This refers to the group of diss tracks that members of Wave and West are dropping on each other for fun. The idea was started by Aiden because, as a producer, he was sitting on a lot of extra beats. He thought it would be fun if everybody traded bars with each other. While the only two public diss tracks are from Aiden, at least one more is confirmed by Baldi by the end of the summer.
L. Jeff. This is what me and Boss named Elliot's axolotl after taking it off of his hands. I really don't remember his original name, but we went out of our way to rename him and call him L. Jeff so much that it basically caught on with the rest of the boys.
Hermit Crab Seed. This one was right in front of everybody's eyes the entire time. For the first season of SMP Wave, we used the same seed as Hermitcraft, as they were utilizing proximity chat on a small island where they could all live near one another. This idea sounded good to us, so we just used their seed instead.
Discord and IP leaks. This refers to the many times the Discord was leaked, as well as the server's IP. Luckily, people have only joined when the Discord was leaked, saving Griffin a lot of hassle. Our latest addition to Wave, Planet Miller, joined through a Discord leak that Servos let out. To be fair, Miller and Griffin had been friends for many years before that leak, so he was probably bound to be added anyway.
Why Shinobi was kicked? Shinobi was kicked for a few reasons. He would always be the one who would cause arguments in the Discord, which wasn't fun. He also griefed Aiden's boat for what he thought would be fun lore, even after saying to everybody that he doesn't want to grief unless he gets permission from the other person behind the scenes. On top of this, he was also caught X-raying and only streamed one time on the server after promising to pump out content all over TikTok and YouTube.
Members that quit. Due to their own reasons, these people no longer play on the server. You guys are always welcome back. Just hit one of us up.
Tom V. Tom V was another member that was kicked from the SMP. He said many controversial things and is known for the time when he was invited to the West SMP just to be caught X-raying 10 minutes into logging in for the first time.
Elliot hacking an X-ray. One day, while talking in a Discord call, me and Boss caught Elliot flying around in a boat. At first, I thought it was server lag, but then it kept happening, and then he later confirmed it. On top of this, he was also caught with the most recent version of an X-ray texture pack. This led us to take custody of his axolotl, El Jeff.
Tom V discovered Aiden's secret. Aiden's secret was supposed to be revealed at the end of the season when he hosted a festival in Pogland with the entire crew. For reasons that we'll get into later in the iceberg, this festival never happened as Tommy discovered what Aiden was doing the entire time.
Rated members. This refers to the members that were only on the server for less than a day and had little to no activity with the rest of the group. Think of them as ghost members, but refers to these people. Everybody I talk to can't recall seeing them in-game, despite being them logged in at one point.
Blogs connections. Despite not having anything to do with Wave, Blogs has a couple connections to the present-day roster. Jude once confirmed in a Discord call that they go to school together. SMP On Air's ending. SMP On Air was supposed to end in a bang. The members of the Pogan government prepared for a gathering which would be called the Festival of Pog. Here, everybody would celebrate the end of the season and everybody boarding a rocket ship and leaving, putting an end to the season. However, more and more arguments would take place on the server, and Griffin's VM for the server was deleted, and the whole world and the server were completely lost.
My secret. So, there's a missing piece here. What does my secret have to do with Poglin in the end of the season? Well, I'll tell you. From the very start, behind the scenes, Poglin was a corrupt government. Whenever I wasn't streaming on the server, I was working on a nuke which spanned across the entire town. The plan was to reveal this to everybody as sort of a twist villain turn to the server and escape to the wastelands next to Poglin that I spent the past month making publicly on stream and get in the rocket. Unfortunately, Tommy found the nuke and set it off. I spent under a week going through screenshots, videos, and streams of different perspectives in order to rebuild Pogland. I didn't want the season not to end in a spectacular manner, but it was too late. The hype had died down for SMP On Air, and it was seemingly inactive. This, on top of the fact that Griffin's server PC died, meant that the plan was never fully carried out. Literally everything we were doing on that server was in preparation of the finale, and it never saw the light of day. Well, at least I got to explain it in a video. I hope you guys enjoy this iceberg. Boss and I spent a lot of time on it. Links to both of our channels will be in the description, as well as any credits where applicable. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you later.